This is the STEAM podcast, Strength Through Expressive Arts Mentoring. No matter where you are in your journey as a musical artist, you're always looking to move forward, but you might not know what's next for you. STEAM is about what's next. We're going to give you ideas, conversations, solutions. You have the confidence. This is about strategy. Well, the clock is ticking on your to-do list. So what can you do to allow yourself to feel most productive and satisfied that you have done what you can to move yourself forward toward your goals without a whole lot of self-criticism? Welcome, I'm Thomasina Winslow, your host and founder of STEAM, Strength Through Expressive Arts Mentoring, and I'm joined by my co-host, Hilary Schrauf, in this episode as we tackle this very subject of the overwhelm. Enjoy. You were saying something, Hilary, about people feeling overwhelmed and the different forms that that can take. Something you were saying is very interesting about having this mental to-do list and not feeling adequate because you haven't finished the to-do list or whatever. What was that?
Well, it was just a sort of, when I talk to my friends who are other musicians and, you know, people I come across and students, I often hear, you know, well, I'm trying to reach a goal in my, you know, I want to get better at X, Y, or Z. I want to, you know, sing more, or I want to get more gigs, or I want to do, but I just get overwhelmed and mm-hmm. then I don't do anything, you know, and I can completely relate to that. Yeah. You know, I have those days myself. And so I guess, you know, for me, I haven't really found a solution. And so we were chatting about that and you came up with a great suggestion for sort of when you feel like there's just too many things pulling you away from a goal.
Yes. And the goal is getting lost in the things.
Yeah. That whole forest and trees.
Yes.
Thing.
Yes. And I have different times try to do something about that. And the thing that I found most effective was to say, okay, wait a minute. First of all, to stop. And like physically stop myself, like freeze, you know. And then.
I love that.
just freeze. I mean, I could be standing in the, you're walking down the hall. Wait a minute. You know, it's like saying, hold on a second, you know. When someone goes on and on and on, you know, you have a conversation, they go on and on and on, and then it kind of borders on the ridiculous, or it gets too much.
It's just too overwhelming.
It's like, hold on a second. And the thing that has worked is I say to myself, what is the best case scenario today? Of all of these things that are coming at me, what would make me feel most satisfied at the end of the day to do? What is there? There may be one thing that's just like, is coming at you. I should do this. Or every time you walk by something, I should really fix that. Or, or I should put this in that closet. Why can't I get it out of the okay, wait a minute, I got something else going on. And then all of these other things distract you, but that thing in the middle of the floor is disruptive to your even thinking process because you're looking at it and it should be in the closet. So you just say, you know what? Best case scenario, I move this, I put it in the closet, and I don't have to think about that anymore.
Right.
So...
So it's kind of the do it first principle in a way, like
this
thing that's
kind
really
of a veiled do it first. Because the do it first is a stressor in itself.
Oh, that's true, I suppose. Yeah.
So
it's not really designed to be that. It's supposed to take like, okay, this is going to take 2 minutes or less, so I'll just do it first.
And I noticed that I have, we use the word priority, but there's priorities and then there's top priorities. So there's more than one kind of priority. So if the top priorities are really irritating to my thinking process, what do you call that? Can't think of the word.
I can't jump in on this. I don't.
It's like, this is your thought.
This is a you thing, baby. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Dissonance.
Oh, dissonance. Yes. Okay.
Something is not quite right until that thing is done, but then you have other things that seem to be priority over that. But again, that box that's in the middle of the floor, that would clear some of that path, literally.
Yeah, and then the mental space.
You get to stop
all this energy into that.
I had a student say to me, I can't completely, I own about half of it, because I had a student say to me in class one time, she said, Miss Winslow, what's the matter? Because I was pensive. I wasn't, you know, I was trying to focus on what I was going to teach them, but I had something on my mind, some things. And she said, what's the matter? And kids are very intuitive, you know, they're sensitive to what other people are going through and what you might be going through. So she said, what's the matter? I said, well, my mind is full, trying to get by giving her any specifics. And she said, well, maybe you need to delete some files. I couldn't say anything because that was just like right on point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So think about what the best case scenario for your day would be. You get to the end of the day. And I have done this where I said, okay, this, you can write them down or just do them as you walk by them. And then at the end of the day, I was just so like, yeah. This is the best case scenario because I feel good. I don't have those things bothering me anymore, and I don't have to stump my toe on that box. I actually bring that up because I actually had a box.
Did you move the box yet? Like, I know.
I did. I moved the box. Okay. I had to get the thing that one thing always leads to the other.
Yes.
So here's the box. I got to move this box into the closet. And then I thought, why put it in the closet? Well, because you're trying to avoid taking all the stuff that's in there out and putting it in its place.
Oh.
Right?
Oh, interesting. You didn't tell me what was in the box.
Yes.
I'm just thinking, oh, you just have to pick it up and move it.
Somebody had given it to me, so I accepted the box of office materials. I did need more binders and notebooks and cords and... And she said, do you want to just take this? I'll put it in a box for you. And it was a huge box. I'm like, oh. But I wasn't going to
turn
it.
Thank you.
Yes. It was like, thank you. And it stayed in my room for 2 weeks. And then it was like on the third week, I said, I really have got to. And every time my mental... And I would even verbalize it. I really got to get that stuff out of there. What is actually in there? Oh, that's kind of interesting. Then I would go on to something else.
Uh-oh.
Box is still there. Then I tried to move it from one part of the floor to the other, and it ripped.
Oh, no.
So I said, I can't put that in the closet because all the stuff is going to come out. I still don't know everything that's in there because, you know. Mm-hmm. So,
yep.
Finally, I hit my foot on it one more time. Fortunately, it was soft. I was like, I have got to get this out of here. Because it was in my bedroom. I didn't want
Yeah, why do you have office stuff in your bedroom?
Shame exactly. It was trying to get it out of the living room, mm-hmm. and I had a, it was a bookshelf that I had just bought, and I said, I want to take, there's some empty space on it, so I'll take those things and put there temporarily until I put them into the office. Mm-hmm. Finally, I said, that's it. But when I said, that's it, I was like on a tear at that point. It's like, I'm tired of this, mumbling to myself.
Right.
It's like, this is like, well, this is really interesting. And taking things out, here's some cords. It's like, I'll never use that cord. That's a, what kind of cord is that? Throw it out. So it created a whole other thing, but the box was empty. Mm-hmm. And not only was the box empty, I said, that's it. I finished ripping it up, and I ripped it up in like little small pieces. Put it in a garbage can, and I said, done. But I was so relieved.
Oh, see? Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, that was the best case scenario
now,
for that
day. My problem is that I will use that kind of stuff to procrastinate from doing the stuff I'm supposed to do. Because I'm like, I love to clean my house. Not that you can tell. We're actually recording in my dining room, but which is kind of full of a lot of stuff because we have a really small house. And, you know.
It relates, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
I
so
put
I'll,
stuff away, and then it's just like, I wanted that. I wanted to read that.
Yeah.
Where did I put it?
Where did I put that? Yeah. There's that. It's amazing for houses with like zero storage like ours. Mm. Somehow we can lose things in here. I don't understand that. but so I'll use the cleaning thing or the, oh, I should really do this or that to avoid doing the thing. So for me, maybe, you know, the challenge is to like identify that actual work thing that I could get done, that music business thing that I could get done that would make my day better, you know, whether it be an actual business thing or a rehearsal thing or, you know, planning thing. So,
yeah, there's music business stuff and then there's performance stuff. And what set me off on that, the box, is because I knew that there was what I saw. The other stuff that she put in there, I didn't see her put in there because she was preparing the box for me after I saw a couple of things that I liked. And I thought, I need another binder. And I was going to go and buy a binder. And I said, wait a minute. So it worked to my advantage to backtrack and say, where do I have, why am I going to buy another binder? Yeah. I have bought things when I've had things.
Yeah.
And on that idea of losing things in a small space, because my space is small too. When I was in Germany, one of the musicians I worked with, I stayed with him and his wife, and he couldn't find something, and he says, the house knows where it is. The house knows where it is. And I do that when I know that I did not go outside of the house to lose this thing. And I always feel so much better if something has fallen from where I put it. And it's just like, see?
Yeah.
I'm okay. I'm okay. So, you know, think about what is the best case scenario. Make yourself happy.
Yeah.
These are inanimate objects. You are the human being. You are to be comfortable.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And these are the tasks that you have, you know, which, if you're doing it right, should lead you to a goal.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you really mean to have whatever that goal is, you know, if it's to make a recording or to get your first gig or to connect with another musician or someone who can hire you or whatever it is, you know, making a web page or a Facebook post or anything, you know, that's going to make your music life, your art life better, you know, that should, you know, doing one little task and kind of acknowledging that that is important,
mm-hmm.
you know, because it's going to get you to your goal. You know, what is it? The journey of 10,000 miles begins with one step.
Yes, and, that's right.
You know, so yeah, say it again now. It's what
is the best case scenario for today? What could I do? What things can I do that will put me in the best mind space?
Yeah.
The best.
So it isn't just getting your to-do list done. It's picking something out that's either jumping out at you because it's bothering you and stressing you.
Yes.
That you haven't dealt with it or done it. Or it's when you're feeling sort of directionless, maybe, or you're having kind of a down mm-hmm. day, because that can happen.
Yes.
You know, depression, anxiety, all of that. There's mental health
why
things.
Why is this piling up?
Yeah.
You know, what can
overwhelm.
I do to mm-hmm. to reduce that sense of, I mean, I'm making up a word, overwhelmshun.
Yes.
You know, I don't like feeling this way or some people feel like, well, I've got all this stuff in rotation and that's a part of their
right, the routines and everything. Yes, I'm a big routine nerd myself. Yes. But
I have to, at some point there you have to shave some of that needfulness away from your energy, pulling your energy.
Right. Sometimes you do have to set your routines aside, at least, you know, keep the bare minimum that will get mm-hmm. you functioning for the day, but then do something that's going to take you toward your goal. Do,
that's right.
You know, and figure out what it is that's going to make you feel happy and proud to be you and,
yes.
you know, thankful for what you have.
Because it you are important. As an artist, our job really is to reflect what's going on in society or to, you know, make commentary on that. You have to have a clear mind to do that. Mm-hmm. You have to clear your mind space to do that.
Or to tap into your emotions. If you're a songwriter or, you know, even an instrumentalist like me, I'm playing from the heart. So mm-hmm. if I'm disconnected from that, my music is going to reflect that.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah, and people will notice that on some level. So it's all about optimizing your artistic output.
Yeah, by cleaning a little space in your head. Acknowledge that thing that's bugging you or mm-hmm. that task that you just haven't gotten done.
Mm-hmm.
And it keeps
coming up.
Yeah, and look at those priorities, because at the end of the day, you want to have done something
that
will make you feel good
yes.
about yourself and about that day.
That is the main thing.
Main thing.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
This podcast is a part of the STEAM Project. STEAM, Strength Through Expressive Arts Mentoring, is a registered trademark and a subdivision of Winslow Productions. STEAM Podcast, copyright 2019. Winslow Productions, all rights reserved.